former Pakistani Prime Minister, Nawaz Sharif, has been sent back to jail after a fresh corruption conviction. The court in Islamabad gave Sharif a 7-year term for having investments beyond his declared assets. Sharif, who denies wrongdoing, was jailed in July in a different corruption case, but bailed on appeal when the Islamabad High Court suspended his sentence in September. His party lost general elections in July while he was in jail. Former cricketer Imran Khan's Pakistan, Tehreek-e-Insaf, won most seats after running on an anti-corruption platform. Security around the court in Islamabad was tight for Monday's verdict. The former ruling party, the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz, had threatened to start a mass protest movement and disrupt parliamentary business if its leader were sent back to prison. He is expected to appeal against his latest conviction. The court acquitted him in a second case. Two Scandinavian women tourists have been found dead in Morocco with cuts to their necks, the country's interior ministry said. Both bodies were found near the town of Imlay in the High Atlas mountain range, near the foot of North Africa's highest peak, Mount Tabqo. The women, from Denmark and Norway respectively, have not yet been named. A police investigation has been launched into their deaths, the Interior Ministry statement said. A poacher has been ordered to watch the Disney film Bambi repeatedly after he was convicted of illegally killing hundreds of deer. Missouri hunter David Barry, J.R., must view the film at least once a month during his year-long sentence. He was arrested in August along with two family members for killing the deer, taking their heads and leaving their bodies to rot. Prosecutors said, it is reportedly one of the biggest poaching cases in Missouri history. On top of the jail sentence of the illegal deer hunting, Judge Robert George ordered Barry Jr. to view the Walt Disney movie Bambi, with the first viewing being on or before December 23,
2018,
and at least one such viewing each month thereafter. During his spell in prison, the 1942 cartoon about woodland creatures shows a hunt to kill the mother of eponymous deer character Bambi. The months-long investigation, spanning several states, led to the arrest of Barry Jr., his father David Barry, Sr., and his brother Kyle Barry. According to a local newspaper, the Springfield News Leader, while the total number of deer taken illegally is unknown, Lawrence County's conservation agent Andy Bonds said it could be several hundred. Barry Jr. received a year-long sentence in Lawrence County Prison after pleading guilt to illegally taking wildlife. He has also been sentenced to a 1-to-0-day term in Barton County Prison for a firearms probation violation, and both he and his father had their hunting privileges revoked for life by the Missouri Conservation Commission. A popular tourist attraction has become the latest Chinese company to show solidarity with Huawei's chief finance officer, Meng Wanzhou, who was arrested in Canada on 1 December. Shannon Mountain Scenic Park in eastern Hainan province said it would waive the $9.65 ticket fee for anyone carrying a Huawei phone. Ms. Man, who was given bail in Canada, faces extradition to the United States on charges of breaking Iran sanctions. Her case has upped tensions with China. Use Huawei phones, shoot grand photos on the mountain, a notice on the Shannon Park's social media account said. We wish friends around the world who support Huawei success and bliss. The offer would last until 29 December, the South China Morning Post reported. But it was met with some criticism among China's social media users, who claimed it was discriminatory. Huawei phone owners are being offered other enticements to they can get a 20% discount at a board in Beijing. Seen in Beijing, bring a Huawei phone and get 20% off. Similar to this story we covered yesterday, https://tqxl19ypqlpic. Twitter, comsogrilov. End of Twitter post by @loceanj. At least one firm has threatened to penalize anyone buying Apple products. A few days ago, Manpower Shenzhen, based LED and display manufacturer, offered subsidies to any employees buying Huawei phones. It also pledged to fine anyone who bought an Apple iPhone. United States prosecutors alleged Ms. Man,
46,
used a Huawei subsidiary called Skycom to evade sanctions on Iran. Between 2009 and 2014, they also allege she publicly misrepresented Skycom as being a separate company from Huawei, and that she deceived banks about the true relationship between the two companies. Ms. Man, who is the daughter of Huawei's founder, has denied any wrongdoing and said she will contest the allegations. Life of Huawei's high-flying heiress. The United States has been investigating the Chinese telecoms giant, the world's second-largest smartphone maker, since 2016, believing that it used Skycom to bring United States manufacturing equipment and millions of dollars in transactions to Iran in violation of sanctions. Ms. Man's detention comes amid an increasingly acrimonious trade dispute between Washington and Beijing. China is angry at her detention, saying she has not violated any laws. Beijing has threatened severe consequences unless Canada releases the executive. Since her arrest, two Canadians, a former diplomat and a businessman, have been detained in China on suspicion of harming national security. United States President Donald Trump said last week that he might intervene in the United States Justice Department's case against Ms. Man if it would serve national security interests. I'll help achieve a trade deal with China if I think it's good for what will be certainly the largest trade deal ever made, which is a very important thing. What's good for national security? I would certainly intervene if I thought it was necessary, he told Reuters news agency. Canada reacted by urging Mr. Trump not to politicize the situation. Our extradition partners should not seek to politicize the extradition process. I use it for ends other than the pursuit of justice, Foreign Minister Chrystia Freeland said. A popular tourist attraction has become the latest Chinese company to show solidarity with Huawei's chief finance officer, Meng Wanzhou, who was arrested in Canada on 1 December. Shannon Mountain Scenic Park in eastern Hainan province said it would waive the $9.65 ticket fee for anyone carrying a Huawei phone. Ms. Man, who was given bail in Canada, faces extradition to the United States on charges of breaking Iran sanctions. Her case has upped tensions with China. Use Huawei phones, shoot grand photos on the mountain, a notice on the Shannon Park's social media account said. We wish friends around the world who support Huawei success and bliss. The offer would last until 29 December, the South China Morning Post reported. But it was met with some criticism among China's social media users, who claimed it was discriminatory. Huawei phone owners are being offered other enticements too. They can get a 20% discount at a board in Beijing. Seen in Beijing, bring a Huawei phone and get 20% off. Similar to this story we covered yesterday, https://tqxl19ypqlpic. Twitter, comsogrilov. End of Twitter post by @loceanj. At least one firm has threatened to penalize anyone buying Apple products. A few days ago, Manpower Shenzhen, based LED and display manufacturer, offered subsidies to any employees buying Huawei phones. It also pledged to fine anyone who bought an Apple iPhone. United States prosecutors, alleged Ms. Man,
46,
used a Huawei subsidiary called Skycom to evade sanctions on Iran between 2009 and 2014. They also alleged she publicly misrepresented Skycom as being a separate company from Huawei, and that she deceived banks about the true relationship between the two companies. Ms. Man, who is the daughter of Huawei's founder, has denied any wrongdoing and said she will contest the allegations. Life of Huawei's high-flying heiress. The United States has been investigating the Chinese telecoms giant, the world's second-largest smartphone maker, since 2016, believing that it used Skycom to bring United States manufacturing equipment and millions of dollars in transactions to Iran in violation of sanctions.